It's no longer about cases and how we're managing COVID. It's about the severity of the illness that people have and how the public hospital system and the health system is managing. And it's managing very strongly. So I commend the work that's been done there. And so with this variant, we know it could be more transmissible, but we also know that it's proving to be less severe.
Australia is one of the best prepared countries in the world. We have always assumed, and Paul has said on many occasions, as has Brendan Murphy, that there will continue to be variations and variants.
What we do know about Omicron is really not enough. There's a lot more that we don't know and that we need to find out. The key questions really are, is it more transmissible? And how transmissible exactly is it? It certainly seems to have spread very quickly in southern Africa.
We need time at this stage to get that information from South Africa. We need to be cautious, but we don't need to be alarmed. We may need a little bit longer to fully understand the vaccine effects, but we'll certainly be able to watch what happens and we'll be in a much better position. And we already know 1,000 times more today than we did 2 days ago about the virus.
The pandemic is not over, but we need to continue to open up our state, open up our economy, keep people back into work. There are many challenges that are in front of us, but I believe the key to success here has been our high vaccination rate, but also to remember that if you are eligible for a booster shot, please go out and get one.
This is a brand new variant of concern, and at this stage it looks highly transmissible. We now know that it is in the country. What we've got to do is to make sure that we're as protected as possible as we increase our vaccination rate here in South Australia. Well, look, we don't have a lot of international arrivals in South Australia at the moment. We did have one group which came in on the weekend. That's why we changed that direction to move from 7 days to 14 days. We don't want to take any chances here.
It is the first case of Omicron in the Northern Territory, but the Territory community should be reassured. The gentleman went straight to Howard Springs, the Centre for National Resilience. He is in quarantine there. He'll be cared for appropriately.
Being cautious works, being careful works, being adventurous doesn't. And so we'll continue to be cautious.